Hey, board gamers, BJ from Board Game Gumbo here, back with a review of Aquatica. We're first going to take a look inside the box, talk a little bit about the gameplay, then I'm going to give you my thoughts on whether this game is one of a potential top 10 games of the year, or is it all wet? Let's find out. All right, we're taking a look at Aquatica from Cosmodrome Games. Let's see what's inside, and I'll tell you how to quickly play. Then we'll get back to the table and talk about our review. So this is the game board that it comes with. One of the guys from the Gumbo said, I'm not sure it's necessary, but I like it for this reason. Number one, it gives you all of the different scoring things that you can use at the top. Part of the game in trying to score as many points as you can from the location cards, you can also score points by being the first person to complete these objectives here. There are four objectives at the top, and they can actually be randomized because the game comes with a bunch of different chips that can go over this part right here. But what I really like about the board is that it helps you with the flow of the game. These are the location areas, and these are all the characters you can recruit. When you scout and move these up to the top, it kind of helps with that flow to remind you that you need four cards to move, and then they'll go to the discard. Of course, once the locations are scouted, you can conquer these for one power less. And that is the game board. That is one thing I don't like. There's some little problems with some of the parts of the game board where it's like the thing is coming off. So not too happy about that board. Then, of course, you get the rule book. The rule book is very well laid out. It's easy to understand. We taught ourselves from the rule book with no problems. Here's the star of the game. Each of the player boards comes with this cool double layered board. Nice thick cardboard. When you get the location tiles, you're going to place them into this section here. And I'm going to show you those in just a second. So let's take that out. There are those location tiles I was telling you about. They're a weird looking size, but they're so cool to fit inside this, inside each of the spaces. So let's say you earned this location here. If you earned this one, you would put it in one of the available five slots and move it all the way up until you see a little hex that you can't move any further. Now, when you need that special power, anytime during your turn, you can slide that bubble and claim that one. Some of these, though, have empty bubbles. All right, so there's that symbol for whenever you're all the way at the top, you can treasure chest this and put that there and score the points on the bottom of the card. Three there. But what happens if you treasure chest this card and now you've got that empty bubble? You're going to need another card or a manta or some other way of moving it, like this card here, that allows you to move one space up, because otherwise you're stuck at this empty bubble. And that is a delicious little mechanic that you've got to figure out. With five different cards and all of them having tons of different special powers, all worth different points, it can be a lot of fun chaining them up. I saw Josh from the Board Boys do like 18 actions in one turn between his mantas, the card he played, and all the locations. And that was a lot of fun to do there. There's those chips I was telling you about. They're double-sided, so it comes with six. You have the standard four already. These double-sided gives you another way to randomize what the in-game points. And that's actually, it's an in-game trigger too, because when one player has placed four of their colored manas on the board, that triggers the last round for everybody. Handy dandy score pad, of course. Nice, makes it easy. And of course the character cards here. That's the king. Oh, sorry, that's the royalty cards first. Special cards we got when we got the game from Essen. That's all the different characters you can buy. Meg is always a popular one. Allows you to conquer a location with a lot of power, and you force other players to discard a character. Where is that angler? Oh, there's a way to treasure up some cards. Everybody gets to do it, but you get to move a card up quickly and treasure it. So that nice seven or eight is going to get moved real quick. On this side, I have the different decks, and there are four different decks. Each are exactly the same except for the symbol at the top, and they all have special powers that are going to allow you either to conquer a place, conquer a location, or to recruit a character, or sort of that Concordia mechanic. Whenever you're ready to pull all your cards up, you play Matrona. It unflips all the manas that you have out there and gets all your cards back in your hand. Speaking of the manas, there they are right there. The star of the game, the beautiful manas. You're going to get some in your color, of course. So if you're red or green, you'll start with some in your color. But during the game, when you get location cards that have a special symbol on them, for instance, that one right there says you'll get a manta that gives you +1 gold. You'll just take one of these purple mantas out of the stack, matching that symbol, and place it on your board, and you can use it immediately. When they're tired, you'll have to find a way to get them back up. But at any time you want to, you can turn this over and get that benefit. This one in particular gives you a one move on any card that you want to. All right. That's basically what comes in Aquatica. Let's get back to the table and I'll tell you quickly how to play and give you my thoughts on the game. Hey, so that's an inside look at Aquatica, a 2019 release from Cosmodrome Games for Europe, but for us, really more of a 2020 release. Hopefully it's going to be, we'll see a reprint this year. At least that's the rumor. Let's talk about the presentation first. Artwork in this game, absolutely gorgeous. From the location cards to the beautiful front cover, this is the kind of game that people are going to look at and are just going to be super impressed when it pops on the table. The player boards themselves are all double or triple layered, I can't remember, but they just are super functional and people are going to love that sliding mechanic and how it fits perfectly into the board. The box cover itself, absolutely gorgeous. The box itself is sturdy, it's well made, it's the kind of box you like. And on the inside, it's got a functional, perfectly done insert that just holds all the stuff. Well made, very well thought out. Rulebook adequate. I mean, it's good. It's definitely better than their last game, the smartphone game. This is a rulebook that we could dive into and get pretty easy. But you know what everybody's going to talk about, of course, besides those player boards and the art, are going to be those mantas. And there's a ton of them in the box, and they're all cute little plastic mantas. And you're just gonna have a blast. I mean, by the end of the game, you're gonna have 6 or 7 of those things, and they're just gonna. You're going to want to play with them as you get them exhausted and flip them back over. I mean, people are going to ask you, what game is this when they see this? All right, let's talk about some quick notes on the gameplay. This is essentially a card game with tiny little engines that you're going to run throughout the game. Players are going to try to score the most points, they call them prestige points, by the end of the game. You're going to do that in one of three ways. The first way is either purchasing or conquering locations. The game, the player boards themselves are these double or triple thick player boards that have little sliding areas where you can put the locations. And when you put the locations, as you slide them in, you're going to get bonus actions. But once you get them all the way up and then bank them into your treasure chest, they're going to be worth points at the end of the game. The second way is just recruiting new characters for your deck. Your hand is how you're going to be playing the cards. But when you purchase them off the game board, the more you purchase, the more points you could score at the end of the game. And the last way, of course, is the goals. The game comes with 4 standard goals on the player board, and those are things like having the most mantas at the end of the game. But it also comes with 6 double-sided chips that have different goals on them. And all of those are the ways that you're going to score points. But you want to do it quick, because the end of the game is going to get triggered when some person gets all 4 of the goals complete. Now, to complete those goals, you're going to have to give up one of your starting mantas. So it's definitely a race between the 4 of them, and it creates a lot of tension as you're going through the game. So is Aquatica any fun? Hey, let me tell you, Aquatica absolutely fires Abyss in my collection. I get the same theme. I get the same feeling of purchasing cards with special powers to help me, and I get that same beautiful artwork. But I get better components. I know it's going to surprise people, but I really like the components in this game between the way the player boards are made and the mantas. You get a more intuitive gameplay. It's very easy to teach. I mean, getting the bonus actions, what to do on those. You know what it is to recruit new characters into your deck, and playing them is very simple. And you get that Concordia mechanic of playing a card to get all of your cards back. I mean, that's essentially the game, right? Playing one card and then taking the special action on that card and then chaining up all those cool little bonuses between your locations and between your mantas and getting to do that so many times during the game. You get all that in this game, and I just think it's a smoother experience than with Abyss. Here's some of my favorite points. I love the way it looks on the table. I mean, this thing is going to pop when you put it out there. Number one, you got those mantas. You got those player boards with the special thickness. You got the board itself, which is not beautiful, but it's very functional. It's got arrows that kind of let you know which way they're going. Of course, you have all those little mantas that you're going to want to play with. They're when they get tired, you're going to be playing with them, and you can't wait to get new ones. You get new ones off of purchasing certain locations, and you know that's going to be exciting. When people walk by, they're going to look at this game and go, wow, this thing really stands out. I love when you get those combos going. A lot of games when other people are taking combos, you know, I'm looking at other games, and that's just you know, that's not my favorite part of the game. But in this game, it doesn't take long because each one of those are little micro bonuses. So it's kind of fun to watch other people get 4, 5, 10, 15 different little micro bonuses and score big, because you know it's coming back around to you. Each one of the turns really don't take that long. I also like how the king cards change up the strategy of the game. After your first game, start using those king cards. Each one of them gives each player a different special power. And they can really break the game, but that's the fun of it. You know, each person having that special power and then trying out a different one the next time. There's more than you can play in one or two games. You're going to see through a lot. Choosing your strategy based on the king cards and also the recruited character cards that come out, that's a big part of this game, because your strategy is going to change every game depending on what that combo is between your king cards and the character cards. Is there a lot of variability? I think so. Just for the fact that the cards are going to be different with the king cards, I realize that the base character cards that come out, it's the same ones that are going to come out in every game. But those goals really change up. You get the four standard ones that are on the game board, but you also get those double-sided chips, which can change the strategy of every game. So I think there's a lot of variability, and there's also a lot of depth. There's plenty of depth in this game for any hardcore gamer, any serious hobby player. And at the same time, you can play this game easily with family or friends, maybe friends that aren't that into the hobby. So to me, lots of replayability, plenty of depth. Are there any downside? Yeah, there's a few. Our board is already, the paper on it is already starting to kind of wear out and flip out. That might be just a production issue of our one board or something, a larger problem that we need to take a look at. The mantas themselves are absolutely awesome. I mean, people are going to, that's one of the things that are going to stand out in the game. But the printing on them are tiny little purple ink print and typeface, and it's kind of hard to read when you have tired eyes like mine. I wish that had come out a little better. And for some people, look, if you don't like little engine building, if you don't like card combos, if that's not your jam, then, you know, this is just not a game that's going to be for you. All right, let's wrap it up. Some final thoughts. I'm counting this as a 2020 game. I realize it's tough to get. Came out in 2019, but not much availability right now. But there's rumors of a reprint. And when I think of 2020 games, so far, it's been my favorite game played. I'm just trying to think if there's going to be anything that would knock it out of a top 10 at the end of the year. If you like card combos, if you like an underwater theme, if you like gorgeous art, if you like the way that Cosmodrome Games puts together just such a great package, and if you're looking for a step up from Abyss, if you played Abyss and maybe it's kind of tired out for you, you got to check out Aquatica. I still think it's going to end up at the end of the year as one of my top 10 games. I have trouble thinking of 9 or 10 other games that would push it out. All right, board gamers, that's Aquatica from Cosmodrome Games, a 2019 game for the rest of the world. Hey, let's cross our fingers and hope that we can get a reprint sometime in 2020. Until next time, laissez les bons temps rouler.